Now you have this sermon or address of Simon Peter. Now listen to this. This is a marvelous sermon. And when Peter saw it, he answered unto the people, "Ye men of Israel." Now, he didn't say, "Ye men of Southern California." He's talking to ye men of Israel. This is the Jerusalem period, friends. We're in a transition period. The church is beginning to move out, but it hasn't moved out yet. No one in Rome has heard yet. No one in America had heard. No one in England had heard. This is in Jerusalem. May I pause to say this, and I'd like to say it sweetly and kindly, but I wish that folk in reading the Bible would bring to it the same common sense that they use in reading other books. This is God's Word, but you don't have to assume some way out yonder viewpoint. This deals with us right where we are, and it's very important to see. Now, will you notice here, and he says, "Ye men of Israel, why marvel ye at this, or why look ye so earnestly on us, as though by our own power, our holiness, we had made this man to walk?" Now, again, he's directing them, friends, back to the Old Testament. Don't look at us, Peter says. This is not because of us. But he said you ought to recognize that it is not the fulfilling, because they didn't accept the Lord Jesus at that time. They didn't repent and turn to him. But the important thing is this, that they were acquainted with Zechariah 12:10. Listen to this. "And I will pour upon the house of David and upon the inhabitants of Jerusalem." Now we're talking about Jerusalem. "The spirit of grace and of supplications, and they shall look upon me whom they have pierced, and they shall mourn for him as one mourneth for his only son, and shall be in bitterness for him as one that is in bitterness for his firstborn." The day is coming, he makes it very clear, the day is coming when this one will come. It hasn't been fulfilled yet. The second time, and these things will be fulfilled. Now, Peter's going to tell him it'd be fulfilled now if you'd only turn to him. Now, again, you have over in Ezekiel, the 36th chapter, verse 27, "And I will put my spirit within you and cause you to walk in my statutes, and ye shall keep my judgments and do them." And then, if you'd go back to the 12th chapter of Isaiah, that, by the way, is a remarkable chapter, just 6 verses, and it speaks of the worship during the time the kingdom is here. And it will be a time of praising God, and "Behold, God is my salvation. I will trust and not be afraid, for the Lord Jehovah is my strength and my song. He also has become my salvation," again and again. And then if you went over to the 35th chapter of Isaiah, again you would find a reference there, and I'll turn and read that right now, verse 10 of the 35th of Isaiah. "And the ransom of the Lord shall return, come to Zion with songs and everlasting joy upon the heads. They shall obtain joy and gladness, and sorrow and sighing shall flee away." They ought to see that in this lame man, there is a miniature for the whole nation if they but turn to God.